Hi friends, welcome back. My name is Anish. Today we're going to go to Halebeedu, which is in Hasan district in Karnataka. This is a continuation of my previous video where we covered Belur. If you haven't watched that video, please do watch it. I will share the link to that video in the description below. Please do watch it and give me your comments. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So today let's go to Halebeedu and explore the Hoysaleshwara temple.
നമ്മളിപ്പോൾ ഹലേബീഡിലേക്ക് പോയിക്കൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ്. ഇവിടുന്ന് ഒരു 15 kilometers ഉണ്ട് ഹലേബീഡിലേക്ക്. അപ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് അങ്ങോട്ട് പോകാം. On the way to Halebeedu, we just stopped here to take some pictures. The nature just looks amazing here. Just take a look at it. This temple was constructed during the Hoysala dynasty under King Vishnuvardhana, and this temple is bigger than the temple in Belur. There are 1248 elephant structures, and it looks as if these elephants are running towards one direction. This is a combination of 7 animals, which is an imaginary animal. It's got pig's body, lion's leg, crocodile's mouth, elephant's trunk, cow's ear, monkey's eyes, and peacock's tail. It's called Makara Rashi. The temple in Belur was constructed by King Vishnuvardhana, and it is believed that this temple is constructed by his mantri. His name is Ketu Malla. He was a big Shivan devotee, and hence this is a Shivan temple. Here you can see that the stones have been first brought in and they have been arranged step by step, and then they started doing the carvings on these stones. You can also see that some of these carvings are incomplete because it is believed that though it took 190 years to construct this temple, it couldn't be completed fully because there was 2 attacks on this temple. One was in 1310 and one was in 1320, due to which you can see a lot of carvings are incomplete, or it is still not fully finished. We had 80 such idols in this temple, but we are now left with only 14 of them. A lot of them were taken away during British invasion. We are only left with the damaged and broken ones now. There are around 108 pillars in this temple, and if you look at them, each one has a unique design. The pillar is made of 5 different parts. The bottom one is called Pita, the second one is called Kamba, the round one is called Kumba, the fourth one is Kati, and the last one is called Barabahaka. Here you can see that it's written in 2 languages. On the top it's Sanskrit and the bottom it is Old Kannada. Thank you. Alebidu was formerly known as Dwara Samudra. During the 14th century, this was looted twice, and after that it got its name Halebid, which translates to old city. This Nandi in Halebidu is believed to be the 7th largest Nandi in India. There is a lake beside the temple, and it is being told that this is a man-made lake which covers around 800 acres. Wow, that's big. Hope the video was informative and you liked it. Please do like and comment, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So I will stop this video here. See you in another video. Until then, bye bye.